Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on combinational circuits. In that combinational circuits, we have to discuss about what is a decoder and what is the block diagram of a decoder and explanation of 2x4 decoder. Okay, first of all, what is a decoder? So before going to the definition of a decoder, first of all, this is the block diagram of a decoder. By observing this block diagram of a decoder, this decoder can access how many number of inputs? N inputs. And it produces how many number of outputs? 2 power n number of outputs. Among the 2 power n number of outputs, only one output is active high based on the possible combination of input values when the enable input is high. Okay, so based on the observation, we can say that a decoder is a combinational circuit that accepts n number of inputs and it produces 2 power n number of outputs. Among the 2 power n number of outputs, only one output is active high based on the possible combination of inputs. Okay, so this operation can be done only when the enable input of the decoder is high. When the enable input of decoder is low, the decoder cannot perform any operation. Okay, so this is the definition and block diagram of a decoder. One of the main application of decoder is code converters. Okay, code converter is nothing but we have to convert one code to the another code. Okay, we have to convert one code into equivalent desired code. For example, binary to gray code. Next one, gray to binary code. BCD to XS3 code. XS3 to BCD code. These are the examples of code converters. Okay, so one of the main application of decoder is code converters. Okay. Next, we can go for 2x4 decoder. Okay, as the name implies, how many number of inputs? 2 inputs are there. How many number of outputs? 4 outputs are there. Okay, this is the block diagram of a 2x4 decoder. This 2x4 decoder, here the first number indicates the number of inputs. And the second number indicates the number of outputs. That means 2x4 decoder can take 2 inputs and it produces 2 power n outputs, that is 4 outputs. Here the 2 inputs are A1 and A0 and the 4 outputs are Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3. Okay, so among the 4 outputs, only one output is active based on the combination of input values, that is A1 and A0. So, because of that reason, this decoder can be called as 2x4 decoder. Okay, so this entire operation can be performed when the enable input value is 1. When the enable input value is 1, okay, the 2x4 decoder can accept 2 inputs such as A1 and A2 and it can produce 4 outputs, that is Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3. Among the 4 outputs, only one output is active high based on the possible combination of input values. Okay, here if the enable input value is equal to 0, the decoder cannot perform any operation. So these four output values are equal to 0 when the enable input of the decoder value is 0. Okay. Now, this is the truth table of a 2x4 decoder. So first, if the enable input value E value is 0, okay, we do not give any inputs. Okay, A1 value and A0 values are don't care. If the enable input value E is equal to 0, we do not give any inputs for the decoder, and all the outputs of the decoder becomes zeros. Okay, next one. If the enable input value E value is equal to 1, okay, A1 value 0, A0 value 0, then what is the output we are getting? So 0, 0, 0, 1. So Y0 is active output. Among the four outputs, Y0 is active high when A1 value is equal to 0 and A0 value is equal to 0 and enable input value is equal to 1. Next one. Enable input value E is equal to 1. Next one, A1 value 0, A0 value 1. Then, what is the output we are getting? 0, 0, 1, 0. Okay. So, now Y1 output is active high when A1 value is 0, A0 value is 1 and E value is equal to 1. Okay. Next, E value is 1. Next, A1 value 1, A0 value 0. So then it becomes 0, 1, 0, 0. Now, Y2 output is active high. Okay. Next one. Enable input value E value is 1, A1 value 1 and A0 value is also 1. Then what is the output we are getting? 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so here what indicates that when the enable E value is 0, we do not provide any input values, then all the decoder outputs Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3 are zeros. Okay, next, enable input E value is equal to 1. Here how many number of inputs are there? 2 inputs. How many number of possible combinations? 4 combinations, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. E value always 1. Okay. If A1, A0 values are 0, 0, then so Y0 output is active high. Okay. Next, if A1, A0 values are 0 and 1, then Y1 output is active high. Okay. Next one, A1, A0 values are 1 and 0, then Y2 output is active high. Next, A1, A0 values are 1 and 1, so then Y3 output is active high. Okay, for each possible combination of inputs, only one output is active. Okay, for this combination of inputs, only Y0 is active high. For this combination of inputs, only Y1 is active high. For this combination of inputs, Y2 is active high. Next, for this combination, Y3 is active high. Okay, for each possible combination of input values, only one output is active high when the enable input value E is equal to 1. Okay, next, based on that, we have to write the expressions. Okay, this is the truth table of a 2x4 decoder. 2 inputs and 4 outputs, and this is the enable input. If the enable input value is 0, the decoder does not produce any outputs. Okay, all outputs are zeros. Okay, if the enable input value E is equal to 1, then only one output is active high among the four possible outputs. Okay. Here, from the truth table of a 2x decoder, we have to write the Boolean function for each and every output. Here, there are four outputs are there. For each and every output, okay, we have to write the Boolean function from this truth table. So first I am considering Y3. Okay, so Y3 is equal to, so Y3 output is active high when A1 value, A1 input value is 1, A0 input value is 1, and E value is 1. So that is E, okay, A1 value 1 means it can be written as A1, A0 value is 1 means it can be written as A0, okay. Y3 is equal to E into A1 into A0, okay. So here in this expression, E value is equal to 1 and A1 value is equal to 1. A0 value is equal to 1. Okay, next one, Y2. So in the output column Y2, here this output is active. In this case, the output is active. The corresponding inputs are E value 1, A1 value 1, A0 value 0. E value and A1 value 1 and A0 value 0. Okay. So this is the Boolean function we are getting from the Y2 output here. Y2 value is 1 occurred when A1 value 1, that means A1, A0 value 0, that means A0 value, E value is 1, is nothing but E. Okay, next one, Y1 output. So Y1 output is active in this case. The corresponding inputs are E value 1, A1 value 0, A0 value is 1. E value 1, A1 value 0 means, so A1 bar, and A0 value is 1 means, that is A0. Okay, next fourth output, that is Y0. So Y0 is equal to, so Y0 output is active high. In this case, the corresponding possible inputs are E value 1, A1 value 0, A0 value 0. So E value 1 means E, A1 value 0 means A1 bar, A0 value 0 means A0 bar. Okay, so from the given truth table of a 2x4 decoder, okay, for each and every output, we have to write the Boolean function. So these are the Boolean functions for each and every output of the 2x4 decoder based on the corresponding inputs and enable input. Okay, here each and every output contains a one product term. Okay, so this is one product term, this is another product term, this is another product term, this is another product term. So four outputs are there. So for four outputs, four product terms we are getting. Okay, here in this case, E value is always equal to 1. Okay, now these four product terms can be implemented by using a logic diagram or circuit diagram for 2x4 decoder. Okay, so here logic or a circuit diagram. Circuit diagram for 2x4 decoder. 2x4 decoder. Okay. Here, how many number of inputs are there? A1, A0. Okay. So this is A1. This is A1 bar. Okay. Next one. And this is A0. This is A0 bar. Okay. These are the two inputs. Okay. Next one is here. One enable input is there here. This is enable input. Okay. It can be right here. Okay. Now, first one is E value is equal to 1 means this enable input. A1 value, A0 value. A1 value is 1, A0 value is 1. So here A1 value is 1, this one. A0 value is 1, this one. This one. So that is AND gate. Here this is the enable input. Okay. So what is the output here? That is Y3. What is the expression for Y3? So this is A1 and this is A0 and this is E. Okay. So that is E into A1 into A0. This is the output Y3. Okay. So next one is here A1 A0 bar. A1 value 1. A1 value 1 means this one. A0 bar. A0 bar is nothing but this one. Okay. Enable input value, this one. So then what is the output we are getting? That is Y2. So Y2 is equal to, so this is A1 and this is A0 bar and this is E. A0 bar, this is E. So E into A1 into A0 bar. Okay. Next one. Third one vachesarki, third output, that is Y1. A1 bar, A0. So here A1 bar. A1 bar, A0. A0 is this one. So, product term, then we are using AND gate. So, here this one is A1 bar and this one is A0. Here, this is E. Okay. So, E into A1 bar into A0. This is Y1 output. Next, last one is Y0 output. A1 bar, A0 bar. Here this is A1 bar and this is A0 bar and this is E. This is AND gate. Then we are getting Y0. So here this is A1 bar and this is A0 bar and this is E. So that is E into A1 bar into A0 bar. Okay. So, two inputs A1 and A0, four outputs Y3, Y2, Y1, Y0, and this is the enable input is connected to four AND gates. Okay. This enable input is connected to here. 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 If the enable input E value is equal to 1, the decoder can perform the operation. Otherwise, the decoder cannot perform any operation. Hence, all the outputs are zeros. Okay. So, to implement this 2x4 decoder, okay, how many number of AND gates required? 4 AND gates. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 2 inverters. So, this one and this one. So, 2 inverters and 4 AND gates are required to implement the 2x4 decoder. Okay. To implement the 2x4 decoder, how many number of AND gates required? That is 4 AND gates. How many number of inverters, that is NOT gates, are required? That is 2 NOT gates are required. Okay. So, this is the circuit diagram or logic diagram for a 2x4 decoder. Okay, so among the four outputs, only one output is active based on the possible combination of input values. Okay, so here Y3 output is also a product term, Y2 output is also a product term, Y1 output is also a product term, and Y0 output is also a product term. Okay, each and every product term can be called as a min term. Okay, to implement the min terms, we are using AND gate. Okay, so this is the block diagram of a decoder and a block diagram of a 2x4 decoder and truth table of a 2x4 decoder, and these are the four possible Boolean functions for each and every output of the 2x4 decoder, and this is the logic diagram or circuit diagram for a 2x4 decoder. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and classmates. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name. So Divvela Srinivasa Rao. Thank you. In the next video, we have to discuss about 3x8 decoder. Thank you.